Right. So what we understand is that this notification, which was introduced back in 2011, March 4th, 2011, was crucial, as what it essentially did is that small acquisitions which were under the scope of the CCI were exempt from CCI scrutiny, provided they complied with a few thresholds. The threshold was that if the target company, if the company being acquired, had an asset base of lower than 250 crores or a turnover of lower than 750 crores per annum, it was exempt from CCI scrutiny. Now, this notification, importantly, was due to lapse on March 4th. However, after speaking to sources, we understand is that this matter, we understand that this notification is now likely to be extended. It's likely to be re-notified. We understand that the Competition Commission, on its part, has already submitted its set of recommendations. It is strongly in favor of re-notification of extending the exemptions. The argument, the reasoning of the CCI appears to be that at this point, they do not have the manpower available to scan all these transactions. So that's their reading of the situation. They have transferred the matter. They've submitted their recommendations to the MCA, which is currently dealing with the issue. And what we understand after speaking to sources is that even the MCA is in consensus, does agree with the CCI about the need to extend it. And this, of course, is also being construed in the larger scheme of things with respect to Startup India. These exemptions will allow for M&A activity in the startup space, and that is the reason that is perhaps inspiring MCA to move forward with this. We also understand after speaking to sources is that the thresholds are not likely to be changed, which could lead to some disappointment. There was a need felt for an upward revision in the threshold that we are unlikely to see. But nonetheless, the exemption, we understand, will continue and that the notification will be re-notified.
Okay, thanks so much, Ashmit, for joining us and, in fact, filling us in. By the